Is that better? Okay. Okay, great. For me too. Okay. What's our inspiration? And how do we translate inspiration into a ring? Like, I get my inspo from like all this beach stuff.
What if you carve something that is inspired by gardening?
It might be fun for us to try to carve like sister moon rings. We didn't design further than that, but we just got excited.
So, sandpaper, here's why it's awesome. You can kind of shape shift it into what you need. So this is what you're going to be using to shape your ring into something, whether it's a band, whether it's a just a simple like right angle and you just sort of taper it. The sandpaper is exactly what you'll be using pretty much the whole time. The sandpaper is an amazing tool to fold up and bend and use to really get in there and make a shape out of your wax flame. The candle is for ambiance and also for your hot tools. So all of these tools are metal, so that means they can cut you and they could potentially make beautiful art. Basically, these can go into the fire and then you can use these to scrape material away. Always pointing the blade. This is the sharp blade. Hold the white part of the handle and you simply whittle. I mean, you just really just kind of whittle and you want to support the wax so that you don't crack it, but you also want to be kind of firm with how you're whittling away. So this is awesome because you get really cool angles. You can carve in really cool angles. And then you can also dig in grooves. You can like really get in there. It's really a cool way to create textures and techniques and to get the wax like kind of loosey and goosey. And then you can use this like pallety end of the crab picker to almost like scoop into a groove or to create shape. And if it's hot, it really does a good job. It moves quicker through the wax.
And so when I am trying to think about how do we actually make this happen, I think about the ring from three directions, like from the top. So looking down on my hand, then from the side. So if you're looking at it in profile like this, and then from the bottom, what's behind my finger. That helps me think about, is it a blocky ring that's the same width all the way through, or is it something that tapers, that gets thinner underneath the hand and then sort of is wider at the top like a signet ring, or is it something else that's totally wavy and organic or asymmetrical? The little pencil that's in your kit is for sketching. I encourage you to either sketch on the kit itself, in the lid, on scrap junk mail you have laying around, whatever. It doesn't have to be a perfect drawing, but sometimes thinking of the ring shape from the top, from the side and from the bottom helps that initial shaping process that you'll be working on with your sandpaper.
Here's a question.
Yeah.
Would you suggest sizing the ring with the sandpaper?
Great question, Jillian. Thank you for asking. So in your kit, you have this little guy, a little belt for your finger. So this is a ring sizer. Basically, you don't have to do anything if you don't want to, other than to make this fit the size that you'd like and then let me know what it is. That little guy, that is a little finger protector. That's a little a thumb guard to keep your little fingers safe and to also really act as a reminder to use safety when you are using especially this is the blade. So always use safety when you're using this pointed away from yourself and just put that thumb guard on as a reminder to be safe with your fingers. Good night, everyone. Thank you.